Hermiston Bulldogs and your Richland Bombers. The Bulldogs entered today's game with a 1-6 record. The Bombers entered today's game with an 11-0 record. Today's game will be conducted under the rules and regulations of the MCC and the WIAA. All spectators are encouraged to root for their team and are asked to display good sportsmanship towards opponents and officials. Spectators who make harassing comments, including those of a racial or sexual nature, will be removed from the field. We'd like to remind you that Richland School District is a tobacco-free school district. Tobacco products and alcohol beverages are not permitted on school property. Signs other than the official school ban and the use of any type of noise makers are strictly prohibited. We hope you'll enjoy today's contest and support our efforts to respect human dignity by promoting good citizenship and sportsmanship in high school and staff athletics. Attention fans, do you have friends and family who want to follow along? They can't be here today or live out of town. Well, this game is being broadcast live on YouTube by our Best in Class TV program. To watch the game, head to YouTube.com, search for Tommy TV, and join us to see for all the action. On deck, a fantastic Friday of baseball. Bulldogs, Bombers, Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we ask you please rise and remove your caps to be on our America with the playing of our national anthem. Thank you. Here come your Richland Bombers.
Good afternoon, baseball fans, and welcome to Bomber Field for a continuation of the 2024 Richland Bomber baseball season. As the Richland Bombers enter today's game 10-0, taking on the 1-6 Hermiston Bulldogs. On the bump today for your Bombers is number 21, Alec Ammerman.
On the mound, number 21, Alec Ammerman.
We'll take a look around the diamond for your Bombers. Again, on the bump, number 21, Alec Ammerman. In left field, number 26, Michael Ravel. In center, number 7, Race Reeves. In right field, number 2, John Simons. At third, number 10, Chris Daniels. At shortstop, number 3, Carter Upmeyer. Second base, number 17, John Corbin. First base, number 6, Dallas Bennett. And behind the dish today, the sophomore, number 5, Hayden Galloway. The Bombers are coached by Grant Richardson, Richland High School graduate of 2001, entering his 11th season, 165-85, and of course the 2018 4A state champions. Hermiston Bulldogs, coached by Dave Padilla, his third season at Hermiston. He holds an 8-37 record with the Hermiston Bulldogs. For this first game, unfortunately, fans, we don't have the center field cam going. We will get that up for our second game today. So do our best to show you all the action from game one. A doubleheader on deck here from Bomber Field, Hermiston Bulldogs and the Richland Bombers. Ammerman winds and fires. Bunt tried to be laid down. 3:59 p.m. first pitch, game time temperature 57 degrees. As you hear from our public address announcer, Michael Valise. Ammerman's second pitch, high and outside, ball one. Ammerman on the season, 17 innings, 10 hits surrendered, 6 runs, only 3 of those have been earned. 8 walks as he swings through that one. And 11 strikeouts, a 1.23 ERA for the senior. That ball way outside and hits the backstop. Ammerman was the first pitcher for the Bombers against the Hanford Falcons last Friday. Came away with the victory in a 3-1 victory for the Bombers as that ball is hit to right field, hovering under it, Simons, and he'll grab it for out number one.
Coming to play second base, number 0, Evan Hayes.
The Bombers improved their record to 10-0 so far this young season. As Evan Hayes will step into the batter's box for the Bulldogs. Again, the Bombers 10-0 on the season. Best start in a couple seasons for the Bombers, sweeping the Kennewick Lions in the first of a couple series. That ball chopped back to Ammerman. Ammerman will take it himself to first and record out number 2.
Coming to the plate, pitcher number 21, J.R. Starr.
J.R. Starr now stepping in for the Bulldogs. J.R. Starr, the leading hitter for the Bulldogs this season, hitting 400 on the year, 8 of 20 as he takes that first pitch strike. Second pitch from Ammerman, outside. J.R. Starr, 8 for 20, 2 doubles, 3 triples, 3 RBI and 6 runs. Fouls that one off to the right. Oh, they got 2-2 the count now on Star. That one chopped to the shortstop Upmeyer. He'll throw it over to Bennett, and that will be a 1-2-3 inning for the Bulldogs. No runs, no hits, no errors. The Bombers' first ups coming up next.
Number 21, J.R. Starr.
Back to Bomber Field here on the campus of Richland High School. 0-0 so far. Hermiston went 1-2-3 in the top, and we will introduce the Richland Bombers starting lineup and their batting order for this afternoon's contest. Leading off will be Carter Upmeyer, then John Corbin and Chris Daniels. Dallas Bennett will round out the top four. Tanner Ortiz will DH for Ammerman. Simons, Galloway, Ravel, and Reeves will round out the lineup for your Bombers. Again, Grant Richardson is his 11th season at the helm of the Bombers. Starting off the first half of the season with a perfect 10-0 record alongside. In the conference, the Kamaikan Braves, again 6-0 in conference, 10-0 in league play.
Leading up for the Bomb Squad, shortstop number 3, Carter Upmeyer.
Leading off for the Bombers will be Carter Upmeyer. Upmeyer on the season, 323, 8 RBI and 7 runs. Takes that first pitch ball from Starr. A couple interesting statistics for this Bomber team as Upmeyer takes that second pitch ball, or second pitch strike, excuse me. 7 of these Bombers have 8 RBI on the season, accounting for 60 of the 72 total RBI. So spreading the wealth is this Bomber offense as that's chopped to the shortstop. That'll be Warner over to first base, not in time as Upmeyer records a single to start off this game for the Bombers.
Now batting second base number 17, John Corbin.
That'll bring up John Corbin, the senior second baseman in today's game. Does play catcher from time to time. Throw over to first, not in time. Corbin batting 250 on the season, 8 RBI, another one of those 7 Bombers with 8 RBIs. Runner goes, Upmeyer slides in there safely as the ball triples out to the outfield. That will be the Bombers' 20th stolen bag of the year. Upmeyer's 3rd of the season. 8 RBI for Corbin and 8 runs scored for the senior. That one popped up to right field. That'll be Neto hovering under it to make the catch. The throw in isn't enough. Hit isn't enough to right field to get Upmeyer over. That'll be Chris Daniels stepping into the batter's box for the Bombers.
Yeah,
this point last season, the Bombers were hitting 259 and only scoring 53 runs against these same 10 opponents to start off their season. So Chris Daniels takes that outside for a strike. So far through 10 games this season, batting 320 as a team with 80 runs scored. Averaging 8 runs per game, as just getting out of the way of that one is Daniels. One now for Starr, and he'll turn around and usher Upmeyer back to the bag. Runner goes, Upmeyer, and the catcher Haginson can't hold on to it, but he gets it enough to keep Upmeyer at third base. 21 stolen bases for the Bombers. Upmeyer's fourth. So the runner only 90 feet away for Daniels. Daniels with 12 RBI on the season, 7 runs scored, 357 average in his senior campaign. Starr leaves that one up high, ball 3-1 the count. Outside as well, and Daniels will take a free 90. Runners at first and third now for Richland.
Have adding first baseman number 6, Dallas Bennett.
I'll bring up the first baseman number 6, Dallas Bennett. Bennett, the second of the Bombers' two-headed monster pitching. Most likely be up for game number 2, but he takes first pitch ball there. Bennett batting 310, again, 8 RBI, and 4 runs scored. Runner goes, Daniels will take second base easily. And the Bombers keep racking up their stolen base total. And Daniels is fourth on the season. Starr throws that one in there. Bennett fouls it off to the backstop. Two-one count now for Bennett. Bennett a little early on that. Third base for Coach Charlie Moody. Handles it well. The foul ball will bring the count to 2-2. Rock and fire from Starr. Breaking ball in there for strike 3 on the inside corner. And Starr will retire the second out of the inning.
Coming to the plate, DH number 25, Tanner Ortiz.
Bring up the designated hitter for the Bombers, Tanner Ortiz. Batting 273 on the season, 3 RBI. Tanner takes that one low for ball 1. Again in the dirt, ball 2 now on Ortiz. And the Bombers last week defeating Hanford 3-1 and 7-0. Scored 10 runs against the Falcons combined in those two games. As Tanner pops that one up to left field. And that will be not caught for out number 3. That'll drop. And that'll be an error that'll score 2 runs for the Bombers early in this ball game.
Now batting right number 2, John Simon.
So an error by the Bulldogs early puts 2 Bombers on the board. Everybody is running with 2 outs, and that will bring up John Simons. Ortiz at second, Starr fires, ball high. Simons 467 on the season, 8 RBI, 9 runs scored. That one chopped towards the shortstop. That'll be Warner. He'll fire over to first. Not in time, though, as Simons gets another infield single for the Bombers in the top or in the bottom half of this frame. Here with two down.
Coming to play, catcher number five, Hayden Galloway.
That'll bring up Hayden Galloway, the sophomore catcher. 500 on the year is Galloway. 8 RBI, 4 runs. You see the improved productivity for this Bomber squad up and down the lineup. 7 of them with 8 RBIs on the season. On it goes. Simons will take second base easily. Star throws out strike one in the inside corner of the plate. As I was saying, scored 10 runs in combined in those two games against Hanford. That's the most Hanford has given up all season. They also played Hermiston in a doubleheader down in Oregon. Hanford taking those contests 10-1 and 13-0. That one in the dirt. Ball three, 3-1 count now on Galloway. Hermiston's only victory coming in a one-run decision against the Ferris Saxons in the first contest of the year. J.R. Starrs 3-1, that one high and over Galloway's head. And that will load the bases up full of Bombers. And Hermiston will call time to go talk to J.R. Starr. Star so far on the season, coming into today's game, 10 innings pitched, 15 hits, 19 runs given up. 14 of those have been earned. 8 walks, 8 strikeouts, and a 980 ERA so far this season. Conference over at first. Or at the pitcher's mound, excuse me. Runners take their leads. Bases in formation. Runners in formation for the Bombers, and Ravel takes strike one from Star. Inside, ball gets behind the catcher. Will Artuiz make it? He will. And that will score the third run of the game for the Bombers. Ravel has one less aboard. It's still a great opportunity to add to the Bomber lead for the sophomore. Swings through that one, fouls that off to the backstop. Ravel, 333 batter on the season, 3 RBI, 7 runs scored. Also one of the Bombers' extra options out of the bullpen. He fouls that one off towards Friendrich Stadium. 10 innings pitched this season, only 3 hits surrendered, no runs surrendered so far. 4 walks and 9 strikeouts. Come on, Mike, let's go, Mike. Star delivers. Breaking ball doesn't break into the zone, though. 2-2 to count now on Ravel.
Come on, Mike, let's go, 2-6, go, man.
That one smashed to left center field, right center field, excuse me, and that will be gone. A 3-run homer for Michael Ravel. Scores 3 runs on 1 swing for the Bombers. And records the 2nd home run for the Bombers this season. The other one belonging to Chris Daniels. Reese Reeves gets a hold of that, slices that one into foul territory. Nobody will be fast enough to get under it, though, and that will be a long strike.
Everybody clap your hands.
Great piece of hitting there by Ravel. Makes this game 6-0 Bombers. Race takes that ball high and outside. High and inside now for ball two. Reeves hitting 400 on the year, 8 RBI, 12 runs scored. He chops that one up to the shortstop. That'll be Warner, throws it over to first. Not in time as Race Reeves will record the third infield single for the Bombers here in the bottom half of the first inning.
Current plate, shortstop number 3, Carter Upmeyer.
And the Bombers have batted around as that will bring up Upmeyer for his second at-bat of the day. Star ushering Reeves back to first base. Fouls that one back to the backstop. Upmeyer led this game off with an infield single to short, just like Reeves reached on. Catches the outside corner for strike two. The ball's in two strikes now on Upmeyer. That one skied to center field. Racing back is Luvanos, and he will make the catch for out number 3. So 6 runs on 4 hits, 1 error, and 1 man left on base for the Bombers. We head to the top of the second inning. 6-0, Richland.
In third base, number 51, Tanner McCoy.
Welcome back to Bomber Field, top of the second inning coming up. And Tanner McCoy will lead off the inning for the Hermiston Bulldogs. He'll still face Alec Ammerman in for the Bombers. That one in there for strike one. And if you're just tuning in to today's broadcast, no at-field camera available for today's first game. We'll get it up for the second game of the day, approximately 20 minutes after conclusion of this first one. That one chopped foul, 0-2 really quickly on Tanner McCoy. 353 batter on the season, 6 of 17, 4 RBI and 5 runs scored. Ammerman delivers fastball, strike 3 as McCoy swings through that one. And Emmerman records the first out of the second inning.
How about in catch number 6, Brock Hagenston?
We'll bring up Hagenston. Hagenston, the freshman catcher for the Bulldogs, 231 on the season, 2 RBI. Emmerman and delivers ball two to the freshman. That one swung through for strike one. Just like that, Ammerman evens the count up at two balls and two strikes. Low and outside, fills the count up 3-2, now on Haginson. Again, Ammerman against the Falcons, a complete game three hitter, only giving up one run and one strikeout as he walks Haginson for the first base runner of the ball game.
Now batting, Sergeant Report, number zero, Isaac Luavanos.
Bring up Isaac Luavanos for the Bulldogs. Isaac, a junior 263 batter. Two RBI and two runs scored this season.
Currently running at first base, number 13, Brody Witter.
Bunt shown by Luavanos. But taken for strike one. Ammerman delivers the second pitch. That one fouled into the Frainer's parking lot.
Got three strikes. Let's go. Put it in play. Hey, somebody on that foul ball. If a kid gives me the ball.
Third pitch outside. Ball number two. Ball number one, excuse me.
Let's go, Isaac.
1-2 count now on Luavanos. That one fouled off to the Hermiston dugout. Again, the two common opponents faced by Hermiston that Richland has also faced. Hanford, again, in those two losses. And Walla Walla. Walla Walla taking those games 12-8 and 6-2. In a home-and-home series, that one chopped to the right side of the field. Corbin to field it and flips it over to first for the first out. Tries to get the lead runner, Woodard, at second, but doesn't. So one out in the top half of the second inning for the Bombers.
Now batting, first base number 22, Tyler West.
That brings up number 22, Tyler West. Senior infielder for the Bulldogs. 200 hitters so far this season, three runs scored for the Bulldogs. Takes that first pitch, strike in the zone for 1-0 count. West chops that one, flies that one, I should say, towards the Hermiston dugout. Strike number two. Thankful to be playing today's game. Forecast earlier in the week was for rain. Ammerman delivers the third pitch of the at-bat in the dirt outside, ball one. 1-2 count now on West. Thankfully, the weather has held off so far, and we're getting these two MCC games played. 2-1 pitch from Ammerman. Swung on and missed. Strike three and the third out of the inning by Ammerman. No runs, no hits, no errors. One man left on for the Bulldogs as we head to the bottom of the second. Still 6-0 Bomb Squad.
Let's go.
Thank you.
now second baseman number 17, John Gordon.
Welcome back to Bomber Field. Bottom half of the second inning. Bombers up again here in the bottom half of the seventh. John Corbin leading us off for the Richland Bombers. Takes that first pitch ball inside. Corbin flew out to right field his first time up. Takes the first two balls high and inside. 2-0 count now on the senior. Swings on that one, fouls that one off to the backstop. Corbin swings and fouls that one off to the parking lot. Strike two, 2-2 count now on number 17. Ravel's homer, right center field homer. 350 out that direction. That one chopped towards the Richland dugout. Beautifully fielded by your head coach, Grant Richardson. Still sitting at 2-2 now on Corbin. Turns on that one and flies that one to center field. Luvanos not tracking it well, but he does make the catch for out number one.
Coming to plate, third base number 10, Chris Daniels.
Chris Daniels now stepping into the batter's box for the green and gold. Bombers wearing their gold jerseys today. White pants. Hermiston in their grays with the purple trim. Chris takes that first pitch ball inside.
Come on, Chris.
That one outside, 2-0 on Daniels. Bombers wore jerseys you haven't seen in a while if you followed this Bomber squad, the cutoff gray uniforms. Daniels flies that one off to left field, and that will drop in for a single. And Daniels wants two. He rounds it, gets caught between first and second, and he gets back to first in time to save the single. Daniels wanted the double, but it wasn't flown into the left field far enough. So he'll settle for the single. Bennett now digging in for the Bombers, and that one right back up the middle. That will be back-to-back singles for the Bombers. Here with one down in the bottom of the second.
Now batting DH number 25, Tanner Ortiz.
Good piece of hitting there by Bennett. Right back up the middle, first pitch fastball. Now first and second for the Bombers, and it'll be Tanner Ortiz up to bat for the green and gold. That one also right back up the middle for a single. Daniels will round third. He'll head home. Luvanos gathers in center, but the throw is not in time. And that will be an RBI single for Tanner Ortiz.
How about in right field number two, John Simon?
The batter's gear being returned from first base coach Jason Martinez. Three consecutive singles on three pitches for the Bombers. That one taken for a strike by Simons. Star the 1-0. 0-1, I should say. Goes to 0-2 with that foul back. That breaking ball doesn't break into the zone. Ball one on Simons. 1-2 the count from Star. Fouled into the parking lot. We'll re-rack it. One ball and two strikes. One, two pitch in the dirt. Makes the count two and two now on Simons. One and two high, or two and two high inside. That makes the count full. So three and two here on Simons with one out. Runner goes, and that will be ball four in the dirt. Runner on third. Bennett comes home to score the Bombers' eighth run of the ball game.
Number 5, Hayden Galloway.
Brings up the sophomore Hayden Galloway for the Bombers. Behind the dish today in this first game. He'll fly that one off to foul territory in right field. I don't think anybody's going to get to it, and they won't. So it'll be a long strike one. Some other games around the MCC today, other than Hermiston and Richland. Galloway fouls that one off. Strike two. Walla Walla takes on Chiawana for a twin bill in Pasco. Up the valley, you have Eisenhower taking on Davis at Davis High School for a twin bill as well. And a good matchup in Moses Lake. Eastmont taking on Moses Lake at Larson Playfields for two. We'll get scores from those games when they roll in. Galloway takes that one for a ball. Rounding out the matchups for the MCC, Hanford taking on Pasco earlier today. That one flown right to the shortstop. Not getting it is Warner. And Ortiz will round third. He'll head home. And he'll stand up with Galloway. A hard line drive off the shortstop's glove, and he gets into second.
Now batting left fielder 36, Michael Ravel.
So we'll have another conference with the Hermiston head coach and J.R. Starr. He misspoke. Hanford and Pasco taking on each other tomorrow at 11 and 1 respectively. We'll get a new pitcher for the Hermiston Bulldogs. We'll let him warm up, and we'll be right back here at Bomber Field on Atomic TV.
Thank you.
back to the bottom of the second inning here at Bomber Field. New pitcher for the Hermiston Bulldogs. That will be number 24, Barrett Stanek. Stanek so far on the season, 12 and a third innings pitched, 13 hits surrendered, 11 runs, 6 of them earned, a 3.40 ERA with 7 strikeouts.
Now pitching for Hermiston, number 24, Barrett Stanek.
Exiting the game for the Hermiston Bulldogs, J.R. Starr, 1 1/3 innings, 7 hits, 9 runs. Only one of those was earned, 3 walks and 1 strikeout. Last time up for Revelle, a 3-run bomb to right center field. The second bomber homer of the season. So he takes that and tries to check his swing, but does go for strike 2. So 1-2 now on Revelle. Takes that one outside to even the count up at 2. Revelle also doubled his RBI total this season with that one swing in the first. Swings to that one, fouls the one off to the backstop. That 3 RBI coming into today's game now has 6. That one in the dirt. Heading home is Galloway. Excuse me, Simons, and he will score the 10th run of the ball game for the Bombers. So 3-2 count now on Revelle, only with one runner on base. That one, ball 4 above his head. Bring up the senior center fielder, Race Reeves. Revelle getting thrown out at first. Bang, bang play there. Revelle caught off guard. And that's the second out of the inning. First pitch. Ball 1 inside on Reeves. Reeves swings on the second pitch, and that's under Tanner McCoy's glove. That will be an RBI single. Reeves trying to stretch it to a double, and he will. An RBI double for Race Reeves makes this score 11-0 Bombers. We reach the top of the lineup again for the Bomb Squad. Carter Upmeyer digs in for a third time. First pitch by Stanek, high and away, ball 1. Runner goes, Reeves takes third relatively easily. On that pitch out, no less. So a 2-0 count now on Upmeyer with Reeves now at third base. Strike 1 catches the bottom of the zone.
You got this, Carter.
Outside makes the count 3-1 now on Upmeyer. Upmeyer 1-for-2 on the day with a run scored. One swung on and fouled back to the parking lot. Makes this count full at 3-2 with 2 down here in the bottom of the second. effort in the dirt, and a walk given to Upmeyer. First and third situation again for the Bombers.
Now batting second baseman number 17, John Corbin.
Brings up John Corbin, second baseman for the Bombers. Takes first pitch, ball inside. Corbin 0 for 2 with a fly out to right and a grounder to short. Strike one, clip in the zone, up and away. 1-1 count here on Corbin. Ball goes outside, 2-1 count now on Corbin. Side, but clipping enough of the zone to the umpire's discretion. 2-2 count now for Stanek on Corbin. Two down here in the bottom half of the second. Any ball three, full count now for Stanek. Runner goes, but Corbin fouls it off into the netting. So Reeves at third, Upmeyer at first. Upmeyer goes, and that's ball four, and the loaded bases will be loaded full of Bombers. Bases are loaded for the Bombers. Reeves at third, Upmeyer at second, Corbin at first. Chris Daniels digs in for his third AB of the ballgame. Stanek delivers first pitch strike. Daniels 1-for-1 on the day, 2 runs scored. Walked his last at bat. Swings on that one. Warner gathers it at first and throws over to first base. Not in time as the throw is high and over the head of West, and that will score two on the unplayable ball. Daniels will deliver his hitting gear over to third base coach Charlie Moody.
Now batting, first base number 6, Dallas Bennett.
And Dallas Bennett will dig in for Richland. 1-2 on the day, 1 run scored and a strikeout. Takes first pitch strike from Stanek. One fouled off to the right. Quick 0-2 now on Bennett. And Stanek trying to get out of this bottom of the second. Two down, runners on second and third. That one lined to the shortstop Warner. He'll throw over to first base. Not going to be in time as Dallas Bennett with an RBI infield single. Makes the score 14-0, Richland.
How about in DH number 25, Tanner Ortiz?
Tanner Ortiz will now step in for the Bombers. 1-2 on the day with an RBI and two runs scored. He chops that one over to Warner at second, and he'll throw to West for out number three. So eight runs on five hits, and two runners left as we go to the top of the third inning. It's Richland 14, Hermiston 0.
In right field number 15, Tate Netto.
Welcome back to Bomber Field. MCC Baseball enters its third inning. First pitch delivered by Ammerman to Tate Netto, ball one. Netto, a 125 hitter on the season. Chuck swings there for ball two. Swings through that one for strike one. 2-1 count now on Netto. That one fouled away, so two strikes here on Netto. That one sky to center field. Race Reeves racing under it, and he will make the catch for out number one. Getting on his horse did Reeves as he made out number one for Ammerman. He'll bring up Warner for the Bulldogs. Strike one delivered. Swings through that one. One ball and two strikes now on Warner. That one just outside for ball two. 2-2 count now for Ammerman. That one, strike three looking as Ammerman records his third strikeout of the game for two outs here in the top of the third.
Now batting left field number three, Cougar Philippi.
I'll bring up Cougar Philippi in the top of the Bulldog lineup. Swings through the first offering for Ammerman. Strike one. Philippi, a 136 hitter, two runs scored on the season. Fouls that one off to the left. So a quick go to on Philippi. Ammerman delivers and swung through for strike three and a 1-2-3 inning for Ammerman. So we head to the bottom of the third. It's the Bombers 14 and the Hermiston Bulldogs 0.
Oh,
Welcome back to Bomber Field. We head to the bottom of the third inning. Bombers up 14-0 over the Bulldogs, and Easton Prano will step into the batter's box for the Bombers. Takes the first pitch, ball outside. Prano pinch hitting for Simons in the order. Prano has assumed the role vacated last year by outgoing senior Andre Ang as the preferred courtesy runner, pinch runner for the Bombers. And done well doing it. 8 runs scored on the year. Andre Ang scored 20 last season, so well on his way to equaling that as he chops one over to first base, but foul for strike two. So 2-2 count now for Easton. That one flown to left center field. And making the catch is Philippi for out number one.
Now batting catcher number 5, Hayden Galloway.
Go ahead.
Hayden Galloway now digs in for the Bombers. Galloway 0 for 1 on the day, 2 runs scored and a walk. Inside brings the count to 3-0 now on Galloway. And entering the day, a 500 hitter was Galloway. And that will be a walk. Galloway's 8th walk of the season.
Now batting number 26, Michael Ravel.
That brings up fellow sophomore Michael Ravel. Force back is Galloway at first. Takes first pitch, low and outside for ball one. Back again is Galloway at first. Ravel. Stanek delivers ball 3. Takes that strike, 3-1 count now on Ravel. For strike 2, full count now on Michael Ravel. Ravel takes his bag.
Pinch hitting for the Bombers, number 24, Jacob Brannon.
His 3rd walk of the season, that will bring up Jacob Brannon for the Bombers. He'll pinch hit for Race Reeves in the lineup. Delivers ball two in the dirt to Brandon. That one in there for strike one. One pitch on the way, high, makes it 3-1 now on Brandon. And that will load the bases full of Bombers here with one out. We'll bring up another conference for the Hermiston Bulldogs as we reach the top of the order. Looks like Woodard will step in to hit for Upmeyer. Still efforting scores from around the MCC. So far, Kennewick is up on Southridge 3-0 in the top of the fifth, thanks to a Dane Chavez and Carter Owen RBI. And Walla Walla up, or down, excuse me, 5-0 to Chihuahua, also top five over in Pasco. Schuler for Chihuahua with two RBIs in that one.
Now pitching for Hermiston, number 13, Brody Wooder.
New pitcher for the Hermiston Bulldogs. We'll give him a chance to warm up, and we'll be right back here in the bottom of the third at Bomber Field. Back to Bomber Field, new pitcher here for Hermiston Bulldogs. Be Brody Woodard, number 13, the sophomore for the Bulldogs, 5 2/3.
Richland, number 4, Josh Woodard.
Be Woodard versus Woodard here for this at bat. Josh against Brody. I don't believe any relation. But Brody Woodard so far, 5 2/3 innings, 5 hits surrendered, 1 run. That one getting behind the catcher, but not far enough for any runners to advance. One walk and 2 strikeouts on the year for Brody. Exiting the game with Stanek, 1 inning pitch, 2 hits, 3 runs. None of them earned. 6 walks. That one chopped by Woodard over to McCoy. McCoy fires home and gets the runner, Galloway, at home. And Woodard will reach on the fielder's choice. That brings up Brad Beck.
Pinch hitting for Richland, number 12, Bradley Beck.
Beck pinch hitting for Corbin, number two in the lineup. Takes first pitch strike on the inside corner. One swung through for strike two. 0-2 count now on Beck. Bringing you a final from one of our games, or marquee matchups around the state. Moses Lakes defeated Eastmont 5-3 in their first of two over up at Moses Lake. That breaking ball does not break enough to catch the zone. 1-2 now on Beck with bases loaded here with two down. Swings through that one, fouls it away. Delivers that one in the dirt for ball two. 2-2 count now with two down and bases loaded. Brad chops that over to Star. Star gathers and throws over to first in time to get Beck and end the inning. So the bases were full of bombers, but no runs come across. And it remains 14-0 Bombers as we head to the top of the fourth inning.
Number 13, Brody Woodard.
Welcome back to Bomber Field here in the top of the fourth inning. Hammerman still on the bump for the Bombers. A new catcher behind the plate for the green and gold will be Luke Parrott. In the box for the Bulldogs is Woodard. Number 13. 1-1 count from Hammerman to Woodard. That one chopped to third base. That will be Beck over first, not gathering it as Ravel. It gets behind him. And Woodard will reach first and move to second on the error by Brad Beck. So only the second runner of the ball game reaching for the Hermiston Bulldogs.
Now batting number 21, J.R. Starr.
Bring up J.R. Starr. Starting pitcher in today's game was Starr. 0 for 1 in today's contest, but 8 of 21 on the year, 3 RBI and 6 runs. One ball high and outside. Again, looking around the MCC, Richland and Kamiakin tied at 10-0 overall and 6-0 in conference play with 70 and 68. Plus 70 and plus 68 run differentials, respectively. Good starts for both of those squads. Kennewick 9-2 and 5-2 in conference. Both of those losses coming at the hands of the Bombers. Walla Walla 4-2 in conference play, 7-2 overall. One foul back by Starr. Hanford 2-2 in conference play, 5-4 overall, with a plus 22 run differential. And Chiwana at 2-4. Southridge, Hermiston, and Pasco rounding it out. All yet to register a conference win this season. Southridge 2-6 overall. They're currently losing to Kennewick in the sixth inning now, 3-0. Hermiston at 1-6 and Pasco at 0-10. Pasco will take on Hanford over in East Pasco tomorrow at 11-1. Late call for time wasn't granted by the umpire, but Ammerman held up anyway. Ammerman the 2-2 to Starr in the dirt. And Woodard will take third base. On the pass ball. So no outs and a full count here on Starr with a runner and only 90 feet away. That one missing just outside for ball four, and Starr will take first.
Now batting number 51, Tanner McCoy.
Starr's third walk of the season brings up Tanner McCoy, 353 on the year, 4 RBI and 5 runs scored. Ball in the dirt from Ammerman. Runner goes Starr and chopped up the middle does McCoy. Runner scores, Woodard throws to Ravel to record the first out of the inning. But a sacrifice by McCoy scores the first run of the ball game for Hermiston.
How about inning number 6, Brock Hagenson?
So one down here for Hermiston. Runner on second, that one's popped up to the right side. Foul territory, Ravel squeezes it for out number 2.
For the plate, number 0, Isaac Luovanos.
Brings up Isaac Luovanos for Hermiston, now with 2 down. And a runner on second, Starr. Going in there for strike 1. Get in. 0-1 offering swung through by Luovanos for strike number 2. 0-2 now on Luovanos here with 2 down. That one chopped under the glove of Bradley Beck, just out of the reach of Bradley. Throwing home, but not gathered by Parrott. That was from Prano. Now the Bombers throwing it around the diamond, trying to stop the bleeding. That'll be an RBI single from Luovanos to make the score 14-2, Bombers.
Now batting number 22, Tyler West.
Strike one to West, delivered by Ammerman. No one in the dirt. Ball one, 1-1 count now on West. West 0-1 in today's game. That one chopped towards the left field side, third base side. Foul territory for strike two. So 1-2 count here on West. Two outs, runner on second. That is Luvanos. The pitch, fouled away again.
Hey, wait a bottle, attaboy. Come on, Tyler, time it. Here we go, base hit.
Another 1-2 pitch on the way from Emmerman. That one skied in the air towards the Richland dugout on the left field side. Bradley Beck under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. So two runs across for Hermiston here at the top of the fourth. Two runs, one hit, one error, and one man left on base. 14-2 as we go to the bottom half of the fourth inning. To Bomber Field, heading into the bottom half of the fourth inning. Leading us off for the Bombers will be Luke Parrott. Parrott pinch hitting for Galloway in the lineup. No, excuse me, Daniels in the lineup, fielding for Galloway. Behind the dish, he takes that first pitch high for ball one. Luke Parrott, a 250 hitter so far this season, one run scored. Chops that one to shallow right center, dropping in for a single. And Parrott reaches first base as the leadoff hitter here in the bottom of the fourth.
Pinch hitting, number nine, Brody Bosek.
Come on, Brody.
Bring up Brody Bosek. Bosek pinch hitting for Dallas Bennett in the lineup in the number five slot. Excuse me, number four slot. Bosek, a 214 hitter on the year. Five RBI and five runs. He takes a hold of that one to left field, and that will be dropping in, foul ball called by the umpire.
What?
Turn around, kid.
Just a hammered ball to left field, called foul by the umpire. Looks fair up here. That's a long strike one here for Bosek.
You're right.
Parrott takes the lead at first. Bosek watches that strike two in there. So a quick 0-2 here on Bosek. Stepping off the mound is Woodard. Breaking ball in there for strike three, and long foul ball to start off the at bat. Ends out with a strikeout for Bosick.
Coming to plate, number 25, Tanner Ortiz.
Brings up Tanner Ortiz now for the Bombers. Ortiz 1-for-3 on the day with an RBI and 2 runs scored. And where's that first pitch for a free trip to first base?
Now batting number 15, Easton Prano.
Bring up number 15, Easton Prano, his second time up today. Pinch hitting for John Simons back in the third inning. Takes first pitch ball. Scrambling back to the bag is Parrott, but nobody covering the bag for Hermiston.
Honey, let's go eat. Come in.
Now one high and outside for ball two on Prano. Water looks back at Parrott from the stretch, delivers the 2-0. That one flown to foul territory left field side, and that's caught by McCoy for out number two.
Now batting, number 5, Hayden Galloway.
Hayden Galloway now stepping in for the Bombers here with 2 outs. Bottom of the 4th inning. Luke Parrott at 2nd, Tanner Ortiz at 1st. Hayden Galloway takes ball 1. Second pitch, ball 2. Quick 3-0 count now on Galloway. Four-pitch walk delivered to Galloway. Bases will again be loaded full of Bombers as Michael Ravel will dig in.
Now batting number 26, Michael Ravel.
That one chopped towards the second baseman, Warner. He'll flip it over to West, and that will retire the side for the Bombers. So bases loaded, but no runs going across the plate for the Bombers. We head to the top of the 5th, 14-2, Richland.
Number 22, Braylon Edwards. Leading off number 15, Tate Netto.
Welcome back to Bomber Field as we enter the top of the fifth inning. New pitcher for the Bombers, as you might have heard over the PA, that being Braylon Edwards, the sophomore. Alec Ammerman exiting the game, four innings pitched, one hit, two runs, not earned, two walks and four strikeouts on 63 pitches, 43 of those were strikes. Heading into today's game for Edwards, six innings pitched, four hits, two runs, one earned, two walks, a 1.16 ERA, and four strikeouts. Netto up to the plate, 1-2 count now from Edwards. Bounce trap toward the right side. Ravel gloves it, throws it over to Edwards, and just in time to register the first out.
Now batting, shortstop number 23, Quinn Warner.
Warner fouls that one off to the right hand side. Warner 1-1 now against Edwards, makes it 1-2 without foul into the parking lot. And Warner sits 1-2 now on Edwards. Warner chops that over to Beck. Beck gathers and throws over to first for Ravel for out number two. Cougar Philippi now digging in for the Bombers. Or for the Bulldogs, excuse me. Strike one to Philippi. 1-1 count now. That one flown over to the left field side, foul territory for strike two. Slow to getting finals trickling in from around the MCC. Chihuahua taking the victory 10-0 over the Walla Walla Blue Devils in Pasco. Philippi fouls that one back. They will have another game coming up here at 6 o'clock. Chihuahua improving to 3-4 in league. Walla dropping to 4-3. Philippi fouling that one off to the left side again. So we'll still sit at 1-2. And Kennewick with the 7-0 lead in the top seventh. Over in South Kennewick against Southridge. That one swung on and through for strike three. The throw over to first. Ravel gathers for the final out of the ball game. The Bombers take game one from the Hermiston Bulldogs, 14-2. Improve their record to 11-0 in overall and 7-0 in league play. Game number two coming up in approximately a half hour. We'll see that game right here on Atomic TV. Ammerman, the winning pitcher in today's game, four innings pitched, one hit, two runs, not earned, two walks, and four strikeouts. Braylon Edwards contributing with one inning and a 1-2-3 inning at that. Losing pitcher goes to J.R. Starr, 1 1/3 innings pitched. Seven hits, 11 runs. Only two of those were earned on Starr. Three walks and one strikeout. Starr on 60 pitches. Again, game two coming up here from Bomber Field in approximately a half hour. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you on the other side right here on Atomic TV.
score, Richland 14, Hermiston 2. Game 2 on deck in about 20 minutes.
Where are we from the bar?